지난 50년간
대한민국은 having led the advancement of science and economic growth of the Republic of Korea for the past 50 years is now beginning the next 100 years to advance the future of humanity. I'll be leading you through today's KAIST 50th anniversary ceremony. I am Jung Jae-min from KAIST Munsul Graduate School of Future Strategy. I am Jang Seon-young and I will be co-emceeing today's event. It's a pleasure to meet you. Thank you very much. I am very excited to be here. We will go beyond the past 50 years and we will mark the beginning of the next 100 years today. Thank you very much for your participation. I hope that you will enjoy today's ceremony and let us begin the KAIST 50th anniversary ceremony. So, did you enjoy the coffee in the foyer? Yes, a very special person handed me a coffee in the foyer. Yes, the robot barista actually served you coffee in the lobby. So it is a robot barista that is developed by a KAIST alumni. And the first performance actually befits the status of KAIST as well. An AI piano developed by Professor Nam Joo-hwan's team of KAIST Graduate School of Culture and Technology and Professor Park Jong-ha of Seoul National University will put up a wonderful collaboration performance. Please give a big hand.
Thank you.
다시 한번 뜨거운 박수 부탁드리겠습니다. 와, 정말 연주를 듣는 내내 한음 한음.
While listening to the performance, I was very excited and I got a lot of inspiration to see how a human and AI were destined to showcase a wonderful harmonious melody. It was indeed very inspiring and thank you very much for this inspirational performance. Next, commemorating the 50th birthday of KAIST, let's have a look at a video highlighting KAIST's past 50 years. Please have a look.
누군가는 말했습니다. 동아시아 어느 작은 나라로부터 시작될 작은 씨앗이 먼 훗날 세계를 움직이는 큰 나무가 될 것이라고. 터만 박사의 예견은 이미 이루어졌습니다. 이제는 대한민국 과학기술 발전을 넘어 세계적 과학기술 발전을 위한 여정을 시작하려 합니다. 반세기 전 최빈국인 대한민국에 작은 희망을 발견한 사람들. 과학기술을 통해 경제성장을 이루겠다는 염원으로 설립된 카이스트. 21세기 현재 세계 10대 경제대국으로 거듭난 대한민국, 그 중심엔 카이스트가 있습니다. 지난 50년간 이공계 최고 인재 배출은 물론 대한민국 경제발전의 기반이 된 카이스트. 언제나 최초라는 타이틀과 함께 걸어온 카이스트는 과학기술의 혁신을 더하며 대한민국을 넘어 세계를 향해 나아갔습니다. 글로벌 가치창출 선도대학.
이것이 향후 50년을 바라보는 저희 카이스트의 비전입니다. 카이스트는 글로벌 가치창출 선도대학 비전 성취를 통해 대한민국의 국격을 높이고 인류의 번영과 행복에 기여할 것입니다.
예고 없이 다가오는 국가적 위기의 순간, 카이스트는 더욱 빛을 발합니다. 밤늦도록 꺼지지 않는 카이스트의 불빛은 위기에 처한 대한민국에 한 줄기 비치자 자긍심이 되었습니다.
한국 과학기술의 요람이자 한국 과학기술의 자존심이라고 생각을 합니다.
의과학을 이끌어가는 우리나라 의과학의 보석.
세계 최고라는 스탠다드를 만들어가는 학교가 될 것입니다.
선구적인 연구기관이 될 것이라고 생각합니다.
카이스트라면 할 수 있다는 기대를 품고 믿음을 심어주신 분들이 있기에 50년 과학기술의 창대함을 만날 수 있었습니다. 이제 한국을 빛낸 50년을 지나 인류를 빛낼 100년. 그 여정의 첫걸음을 지금 내딛고자 합니다.
Yes,
we have now officially opened the KAIST 50th anniversary ceremony with a video highlighting its beginning, future, promise to the Korean people. So the first satellite in Korea, first humanoid, and first astronaut in Korea, KAIST has indeed achieved a series of innovations. So I was also inspired by the video, and I'm sure that everyone who was watching it were also inspired. Now, today, we are joined by many distinguished guests from home and abroad, physically and virtually. So we have online participants as well joining us. A lot of KAISTians. Can you wave for us, for the audience? Yes, we can see a lot of people joining us virtually. Let us have some talk with our online participants. So on the first row to your left, we have Mr. Kwon Young-san.
네, 들리세요?
Hello, can you hear me? Yes, can you briefly introduce yourself?
네, 현재 미국 실리콘밸리
Hello, I'm currently based in Silicon Valley, working for Google. I received PhD in 2005. My name is Kwon Ung-sung. So you also have a son sitting next to you with a KAIST cap. We can say that he is an alumni of KAIST as well. So as an alumni of KAIST, what do you expect for KAIST in the future? I'd like to congratulate the 50th anniversary of KAIST, and I hope that it will become a world-leading university in the next 100 and 200 years. Good luck. Yes, so that was our talk with our first online participant. And if you look at the faces of everyone joining us virtually, you can see many people are joining us from all around the world. Now, next to Mr. Kwon, we have Aaron. Hello.
Hi. Could you please introduce yourself?
Oh, hi, everyone. My name is Aiden Binaga. I'm from Ethiopia. Currently, I am finalizing my master's degree in civil and environmental engineering department. I'm going to graduate this Friday, hopefully.
네, 여러분 박수로 한번 환영을 부탁드리겠습니다. 네. Welcome. And today, for today, could you say a few words for today and for KAISTian?
Well, I would like to say congratulations for everyone. It's a very big program and it's a very big achievement. So I'm sure everyone is very proud of this work. Mm-hmm. I have been in KAIST for 2 years and I have experienced a lot of things. So congratulations.
Thank you for your answer. 여러분 다시 한번 박수 부탁드리겠습니다.
Please give a big hand to our online participants. Yes, we are faced with a non-contact or on-tact era, and as you can see, we're joined by so many people around the world joining us virtually. Now we're going to move on to the opening declaration, which will be done by our two distinguished guests who are physically present today, Chairman Kim Woo-sik of KAIST and 2020 Cybathlon gold medalist Kim Byung-uk will be joining us up on stage. Please welcome them with a big hand.
넘나
Yes, for the past 50 years, we have achieved historic moments. Now I'd like to ask you to declare the opening. Hello everyone, I am Woo-sik Kim.
오늘 개식 선언은 2020년 사이베슬론
I am extremely honored to declare the opening of today's ceremony with 2020 Cybathlon gold medalist and a dear KAIST family member, Kim Byung-uk. I would like to ask you to give a warm round of applause to Byung-uk Kim, who brought hope to the Korean people with KAIST technology. Hello, everyone. Thank you very much for inviting me to this meaningful event. I vividly remember the day when I wore the robot suit first and stood on my 2 feet to compete in Cybathlon. I have utmost confidence in KAIST that it will continue to lead the development of technologies for the disadvantaged persons, and I support your efforts. Despite the COVID-19 challenges, KAIST is celebrating its 50th anniversary, and we have prepared today's ceremony to renew KAIST's commitment to the Korean people. I would like to extremely thank all the participants joining us today, including our sponsors, as well as our online participating alumni, students, and staff and faculty. In particular, I am extremely happy to be here together with our alumni overseas who are committed to their researches and their businesses. I feel like this contactless or virtual meet ceremony is bringing us together. And I would like to also thank the efforts of the faculty, the presidents who have led the establishment and the beginning years of KAIST, and also the commitment and dedication shown by the faculty and students. You all made KAIST today possible. I would like to express my sincere gratitude and congratulations. The 50th anniversary ceremony goes beyond just celebrating our 50th birthday. We are going to renew our commitment for achieving more challenges and dream for the future in front of the Korean people. So joined by Mr. Kim Byung-uk, I would like to officially declare open the anniversary ceremony celebrating KAIST's 50th birthday. If I say leading Korea, KAIST leading, being a leader in Korea, please respond by saying leading the world. We will renew our commitment to, and we will replace the opening declaration with this chant. So on the count of three, I'm going to say first with Mr. Kim. Leading Korea, leading the world for the next 100 years. Thank you very much.
한국을 빛낸 50년.
Yes, thank you very much. So that was leading Korea today and leading the world tomorrow. Thank you very much, Chairman Kim Moon-sik, as well as Kim Byung-uk for your hard work. Thank you very much. And as our distinguished said, we are going to go beyond just celebrating our 50th anniversary. It is a new beginning to advance towards the new future. So thank you very much for your hard work. Now, we will move on to the next part of the program. So next is the national ceremony, and I would like to ask our guests physically present to rise and face the national flag up on the screen. And also, online participants, please face the Korean flag on your screen. Thank you.
네, 모두 자리에 앉아 주시면.
As you were, thank you.
자, 카이스트 개교 50주년
Now, next we have the part to listen to the congratulatory remarks by distinguished guests. And now first is by His Excellency President Moon Jae-in of Korea. Although he wasn't able to be here today as the nation still grapples with an unprecedented pandemic, he has sent us a video message to congratulate KAIST's new beginning. And now, here is President Moon. Honorable KAIST students, alumni, faculty and staff. As KAIST marks its 50th anniversary, we look back on Korea's history of challenge and innovation in science. I am pleased that KAIST is beginning a new dream going forward. I congratulate KAIST on its 50th anniversary along with the people of Korea. For the past 50 years, the dream of KAIST was the dream of Korea. Korea's dream of becoming a science nation was also the dream of its scientists. Korea is now number one on the Bloomberg Innovation Index, and its IMD competitiveness in science infrastructure is at number three, such is the science and technology competency of Korea. KAIST has produced 14,500 PhDs and nearly 70,000 advanced professionals in science and technology, and has become the pride of Korea. KAISTians, members of the science and technology community, in Korea's journey of challenge and innovation, KAIST was always there. KAIST was always at the forefront of new technology development, including the world's second and Korea's first internet system construction and the launching of Korea's first satellite, KITSAT-1. KAIST brought a creative energy to all areas of academia and industry. KAIST was also the first institution in Korea to launch a materials, parts, and equipment consultation group that gave the nation self-confidence in facing Japan's export prohibitions. Recently, KAIST developed a mobile clinic module which showcases the creativity of K disease control. Today, KAIST is a leading global university and research institution. In the 50 years to come, the achievements of KAIST will lead not only Korea but the world, and will accelerate the development of humanity. In this rapidly changing era of climate change and the fourth industrial revolution, we look to KAIST to pave the path towards coexistence of nature and humans and sustainable prosperity. Korea was the fifth country in the world to reach R&D of 100 trillion won. The government will do its best to support KAIST. We will develop technologies and nurture professionals who can lead the world from daily matters such as carbon neutrality and disease response to challenging areas such as space technology. We will double the budget for basic science and increase support for postdoctoral programs to provide more opportunities to young scientists. For outstanding research outcome to be correctly valued in the market and to quickly lead to investment and jobs, we will strengthen the innovation ecosystem by innovating regulations and vitalizing ventures. We will also create an atmosphere most beneficial to research. Honorable members of the KAIST community, please continue to dream bigger dreams. The Korean people treasure and support our scientists. There are many bright young people who are inspired by you to become scientists. When you are exhausted from endless research, please remember that your work is improving the life of Koreans and all humanity, and have pride in what you do. Your passion is Korea's passion. Your future is Korea's future. Thank you. Thank you very much. A warm round of applause, please. Thank you very much. That was His Excellency President Moon Jae-in once again. Thank you very much. He mentioned that the dream of KAIST was the dream of Korea. I hope that we can keep dreaming big dreams. And I will also do my part in supporting you. And yes, we also have congratulatory messages from other countries. Now, it is from someone who also has a very good understanding of KAIST. And it is from Chairman Klaus Schwab of the World Economic Forum.
Dear members of the KAIST community, it is my great pleasure to address you on KAIST's 50th anniversary. I know what a special milestone 50 years are, as we just celebrated the World Economic Forum's 50th anniversary last year. KAIST has been a valued partner of the Forum for a long time, and an institution that I'm proud to be part of through the honorary doctorate you conferred to me in 2015. We are delighted also to include KAIST as a member of the Forum's Global University Leaders Forum community, or GALF. GALF gathers the presidents of the world's leading research universities to identify and to address the key challenges and opportunities related to their key missions, teaching, research, and societal contribution. And we are glad to see that together with the Korean government and the World Economic Forum, KAIST plays an active and responsible role in exploring the challenges posed by artificial intelligence, blockchain, and precision medicine through the Korea Policy Center for the Fourth Industrial Revolution. This center fits well into the work of our global network of World Economic Forum Centers for the Fourth Industrial Revolution, which help establish global tech governance principles for this new era of innovation. Finally, KAIST is a leader in ensuring social inclusion. Founded with the support of USAID, today it is paying its forward and sharing the same support through the KAIST Kenya project. So I warmly congratulate KAIST again on a successful first 50 years and look forward to the next half century as both KAIST and the World Economic Forum work together to improve the state of the world. My very best wishes.
네, 박수 부탁드리겠습니다.
Once again, a big hand, please. Thank you very much. Let me thank Chairman Schwab on behalf of everyone here today. So we have just heard from two distinguished guests for the congratulatory messages, and now it also once again reminds me of all the hard work and dedication of all those who have enabled KAIST. Yes, so it was exactly 50 years ago, in 1971, that KAIST was founded with the mission of scientific development of Korea. At the center of this historic project was one man who led the birth of KAIST. It is none other than Dr. Jung Geun-mo. Yes, that's right. So now, ladies and gentlemen, here is Dr. Jung Geun-mo, the witness to the history of KAIST. Please welcome him with a big applause. Good morning, everyone. This is Jung Geun-mo. Half a century ago, Korea began a historic experiment. A country many predicted will not recover even 100 years after the Korean War. This country became a true developed country within 30 years. And this is where it all began. KAIST. This is where the miracle began. So why don't we go back in time by half a century. Now, this is also the report suggesting the establishment of KAIST, and let us all take a look.
뉴욕타임즈에 미국 국제개발처 USAID 처장의 임명 보도가 실렸다. 정근모 박사의 멘토였던 존 헤너 미시건 주립대학 총장이었다. 이 소식을 접한 정근모 박사는 하버드대 행정대학원 시절 작성한 논문을 들고 워싱턴으로 찾아갔다. 마침 미국의 대외원조 패러다임을 식량, 의복 등 물자 지원에서 교육, 기술 중심 원조로 전환하는 구상을 세우고 있던 헤너 처장은 정 박사의 논문을 읽고 USAID 사업계획서로 고쳐 써달라고 부탁한다. 이에 정근모 박사는 한국의 응용과학 및 공학전문대학원을 설립하는 안건이라는 사업제안서를 만들어 제출했다. 정 박사의 제안서를 바탕으로 헤너 처장은 박정희 대통령에게 새로운 이공계 특수대학원 설립을 권고하는 서한을 보냈다. 이후 경제기획원 및 과기처의 전폭적인 지원으로 정근모 박사의 이공계 특수대학원 설립안은 일사천리로 진행되었다. 1970년 여름 USAID는 한국과학원 설립 타당성 조사단을 파견하였다. 실리콘밸리의 아버지라 불리는 스탠포드 부총장 프레데릭 터만 박사. 그가 이끈 조사단은 약 5개월의 조사 과정을 거쳐 그해 12월 일명 터만 보고서를 제출한다. 카이스트 설립의 청사진을 담은 터만 보고서는 여러 과학자의 공동 성과물이었다. 이들 모두 USAID에서 엄선한 미국 과학기술계의 최고 인사들이었다. 터만 보고서가 제시한 카이스트의 사명은 이공계 교육의 불모지인 대한민국에 제대로 된 대학원 교육을 통해 두뇌 유출을 막고 산업화에 절실히 필요한 고급 과학기술 인재를 배출하는 것이다. 터만 보고서는 이를 실현하기 위해 몇 가지 제도적 장치를 제시했다. 먼저 우수한 교수진과 학생이 연구와 학업에 전념할 수 있는 최고의 환경을 제공. 이러한 정부의 지원은 국가산업에 직접적으로 기여할 수 있는 전략적 연구개발을 전제로 했다. 고급 인재 양성과 전략적 연구로 산업화에 기여하기 위해서는 긴밀한 산학협력이 이루어져야 한다고 제언하였다.
Looking ahead, Korea, an advanced institute of science and technology, will by year 2000 be a great institute of technology with an international reputation, and will have become the model for a number of analogous institutions in other lands.
카이스트는 밀가루.
When the country was short of even food to eat, it still boldly invested in science and technology. In the historic experiment that was KAIST. Thus, the dream of scientists was so achieved. Now, let us hear from KAIST's first president, who is also an alumni, President Shin Seong-chul. On the past 50 years of achievements and also our dreams and vision for the future.
네, 신성철 총장님이십니다.
Yes, ladies and gentlemen, this is Shin Seong-chul, president of KAIST. Thank you, Dr. Chung Geun-mo. He has just handed over the Terman report to President Shin Seong-chul. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. This is Shin Seong-chul, president of KAIST. It is a great honor and pleasure to be hosting our 50th anniversary, both online and offline, with distinguished guests, faculty members, alumni, and students. Let me first sincerely thank the distinguished guests from home and abroad, including President Moon Jae-in of Korea, Chairman Klaus Schwab of the World Economic Forum, for gracing us with their congratulatory remarks. Half a century ago, Korea was planning to go from an agricultural country to an industrial country. But no one was certain if such plan would work due to the dearth of engineers and scientists who would lead and back the shift to an industrial economy. But the determination and dedication of scientists and government visionaries who dared to look beyond the historic horizon and also with the $6 million grant from the USAID, the special law on KAIST was enacted in 1970. And in 1971, KAIST was born as the first research-centric university of Korea. The ambitious dreams and vision of the Terman report of 50 years ago have mostly come true. Science and economy in this nation went on a breathless path of development, and KAIST has been there along the way. It played an instrumental role in industrialization and information innovation, so much so that it is seen as the nation's emblematic school, with many saying that Korea would not be what it is today without KAIST.
휴고가 센스 있게 나와서 저를 좀 도와주려고 그러네요.
So I see that Hugo is here to help me. Thank you. Thank you. Such a smart and sensible robot. This report is very important, so you have to keep it with you for the next 50 years. So you're free to go. The school has produced 14,500 PhDs and 70,000 alumni since its inception, who have gone on to become key members in industries, academia, research centers, and government organizations. For example, 23% of Korean leaders in science and technology and 25% of PhDs in the Korean world-leading semiconductor industry are from KAIST. The school also created the history of startups in Korea as the cradle of tech startups. The around 1,200 startups by alumni have created 50,000 jobs and also are recording 14 trillion won in annual sales. In terms of startups alone, KAIST is the most successful project by the Korean government given its grant in the past half century.
KAIST also plays the role of an emergency medical squad in science technology, saving the country from crisis. In August 2019, as soon as Japan imposed sanctions on exports, our institute launched the KAIST Advisory Group on Materials, Parts and Equipment to provide technical advice to businesses. Also, to overcome COVID-19, we have launched COVID-19 R&D Initiative Task Force to develop mobile negative pressure room system, thereby focusing on developing core technologies to respond to COVID-19. And now, KAIST holds the status as world-class university recognized for its global excellence. KAIST was ranked third in the QS's Young University Under 50 Years Old. In particular, KAIST ranked number one in the Asia-Pacific region for three consecutive years since 2016 as the most innovative university, as well as 11th in the world. KAIST's achievements as such were possible thanks to the massive assistance from the government, the unrelenting support from the Korean people, and the passion and dedication from KAIST members. I would like to take this opportunity to thank the government, National Assembly, Korean people, and all KAIST members. Please give each other a big round of applause. In particular, I would like to sincerely thank everyone who has made large sums of donations, pinning their hope for Korea's future on KAIST. If in the last half a century, science and technology advanced national economy and industry to make Korea a livable country, in the next 50 years, science and technology should contribute to making Korea a livable country in all aspects, from the politics, economy, society, health, to security. The historical experiment of Korea, KAIST, has inspired indeed hope to many developing countries by modernizing the economy based on science and technology. Now it is time for KAIST to start a new chapter of inclusive innovation, set on a new journey of science and technology for all, going beyond the Korean Peninsula to solve common human challenges. As we begin the new 50 years, we are now marching toward the nation and humanity. Building on the successful heritage that we have achieved in the past half century, we have created a vision of becoming a global value-creating leading university and is about to set on a challenge and innovation toward our second dream. To realize our second dream, we will pursue the C-Cube, that is spirit of challenge, creativity, and caring, to lead innovations in five areas of education, research, technology, commercialization, globalization, and future strategy in order to realize our vision. To innovate education, we will foster creative leaders who can create global values. We at KAIST will foster C-Cube talents, equipped with challenging spirit, unafraid to take the uncharted path, creativity to propose convergence-based ideas, and caring mind based on inclusiveness and social responsibility. To this end, we will promote Convergence Talent Department for interdisciplinary education, and with AI education as the core engine of the fourth industrial revolution, we will strengthen global leadership. Therefore, we will make sure that KAIST talents will thrive as global innovators leading the fourth industrial revolution and become the main players in creating the 21st century of human prosperity and happiness. As for the Innovation for Project, we will explore new disciplines to address challenges. We will conduct research and development driving the fourth industrial revolution megatrends of hyperconnectivity, superintelligence, and metaconvergence, and support long-term future-oriented flagship researches for human prosperity and happiness in the areas of climate change, contagious diseases, biomedical, energy and environment, smart technology, post-AI, in order to pursue global excellence. In the era of fourth industrial revolution where winner takes it all, the best, the first, and the only research findings alone will be significant for our nation. To this end, we will push for a super generation collaboration lab that inherits and develops academic heritage through generational collaboration and a singularity professorship that provides a long-term support to singular researches of creative ideas. We will innovate for technology commercialization to realize entrepreneurship university. Universities in the 21st century need to consider technological commercialization as an important mission together with education and research, as it translates R&D outcomes into economic values. Given that the 97% of SMEs represent only 70% of exports in Korea, it is nationally crucial to foster technology-based startups. We will inherit and develop the entrepreneurship academic culture of KAIST, which is the cradle for university startups. To this end, we will introduce entrepreneurship and startup as mandatory course, strengthen startup KAIST, which supports the faculty and students to set up shop, and establish the KAIST bridgehead in the global startup mecca of Silicon Valley. We will also innovate for globalization to become the bridge of the world. KAIST's success story achieved in half a century is highly reputed by the international community, and many countries are making requests to establish KAIST in their countries. The first case is KAIST Kenya. We exported our successful education model in a turnkey approach to establish KAIST in Kenya. We will leverage our experience of operating KAIST in Kenya to establish KAIST in 10 countries around the world in 50 years to come. It will be an opportunity to export K-universities and a very meaningful national project to push the envelope of the Republic of Korea to all over the world. We will open the future of Korea based on science and technology by innovating our future strategy. Korea has developed based on a catching-up strategy in the last half century. Now it is necessary to change the paradigm to a leading strategy to join the advanced countries. Considering that the upcoming future is the era of technological hegemony based on fourth industrial revolution, a global strategy based on science and technology is crucial. To this end, we will launch the Global Strategy Research Institute, or GSI, which will be a global think tank, to present national leading strategies based on science and technology, and to present insightful solutions to global issues faced by the human society in the 21st century. Through such innovation, we at KAIST hope to achieve 10-10-10 dream in the next 50 years. This is to produce 10 singularity professors who have achieved global research achievements, foster 10 decacon startups that create 10 trillion won worth of corporate value, and establish KAIST in 10 countries around the world. Through this, we will realize the vision of global value creation leading university to give hope and pride to the nation and the people, and further contribute to the prosperity and development of mankind. We look forward to your support and attention to KAIST's energetic journey towards our second dream. Thank you very much. Then we will now listen to the story of our four young professors who will achieve their second dream in their field of research. First, please welcome with big hand Professor Park Kae-won.
네, 여러분 안녕하십니까? 저는 로봇공학을
전공하는 Hello, I am Park Hye-won from Mechanical Engineering, studying robotics. I wish to explore with you how the robot technology is going to develop and how it is going to change mobility of the future. With continued advancement of robot hardware and software technology, there will be robotics in the not-too-distant future that will exceed human motor and cognitive abilities. First, robotic hardware will develop in various areas such as artificial muscles that are supple yet strong, artificial skin that is tactile and can sense temperature, and skeletons that are made lighter with better material technology, which will make the robot not just human-like but superhuman with greater agility and awareness. Next, in software, artificial intelligence and control technology will develop beyond the human motor and cognitive abilities to equip the robot with intelligence that will allow it to perform complex tasks. So these robots of the future will perform tasks that are too dangerous for humans, like in industrial disaster relief, space exploration, and military areas. Hopefully, the industrial accident rate will go down to zero with robots handling all the dangerous work. And mobility in the future will be quite different. No more cars, to be replaced by omnipurpose unmanned Kaistram that is shared by everyone. We can move people or goods from A to B anywhere in the world without traffic congestion. And VR technology that combines robotics with AI will remove spatial barriers for humankind. We can be educated through digital avatars by accessing robots without physical barriers, interact with others, even go on vacation or conduct scientific experiments. This will mean a true artificial human mobility. Enabling new robotics also requires research into new materials. And now, regarding this, Professor Yeom Ji-hyun will tell us more. Good morning, this is Yeom Ji-hyun from Material Engineering. In materials research, the next 50 years will bring about innovation at a scale smaller than the nano. It is the new material technology that controls the state of electrons by adjusting the atomic array. The electrons that determine the property of materials have unique orientation through their rotation and revolution. If we apply orientation called chirality to the atomic array, we can enhance the material's property or create completely new properties. Then we could develop new materials like Kai-steel that is light but has strong physical properties. Such material will no doubt be immensely helpful in realizing the kind of robots envisioned by Professor Park Hye-won. Kaistronic material with such chirality can also be used for next-generation information computing. There is growing interest in big data in this fourth industrial revolution with various applications. Not only that, individuals are generating huge amounts of data, such as video. And with such data being shared over social network platforms, use of data and memory are growing exponentially. Now, one problem here is the power consumption necessitated by data processing. To run one data center requires 6 thermal power plants, and the associated issues of energy and environment will become even worse. Today, energy efficiency is quite low because electrons process and compute data as they physically move the circuits, which produces heat and wastes power. But Kai-spin, based on spin wave, can be a new option. Spintronics, studied by several professors of KAIST, can be realized through the Kaistronics material with chirality. With the atomic array with chiral orientation, the electron's spin can be adjusted to enable ultra-low power operation, and the spin pulses can move long distances with higher efficiency.
New materials will be crucial in addressing environmental and human problems for the next 50 years by letting us overcome the limitations of physical and electron properties. Now, in a nearer future, we will go beyond AI to the post-AI era. Now, Professor Shin Ki-jung, can you tell us how AI will change our lives? Good morning, this is Shin Ki-jung from AI Graduate School. Humans have opened up the era of AI by training AI in the past 50 years. The next 50 years will be about AI educating humans. AI will develop on its own through interactions with students and will find the most effective and efficient pedagogy. It will move away from existing barriers of subjects or departments and provide customized learning for individuals' interests and aptitude and help them unleash their utmost potential. Such change in education paradigm is an extension of AI Tutor, one of the research projects in KAIST. With the help of AI, humankind will absorb enormous amounts of knowledge quickly, leading to more knowledge being generated. This virtuous cycle will allow us to overcome our intellectual limitations, and it will bring us closer to the superhuman era. And I also wish to focus on KAIST's role in the future that will be determined by quantum computing. Digital transformation of the past 50 years has altered many parts of our lives. Next 50 years, we'll see quantum transformation, where quantum computing will seep into every corner of our lives. In other words, quantum computing will go beyond the development stage, moving more into the application stage. In the computer system area, KAIST is already leading the world, and we are also now leading the development in quantum computing in programming language, operation system, computer security, and also we have the compiler technology that can automatically translate classic programs into quantum programs, which will allow the use of quantum computing for everyone. And this will also help with the forecast and also end traffic congestion and develop new drugs. Now then, Professor Zhu, can you tell us about the bioscience in the future that will be further advancing through AI? Hello everyone, I am Ju Young-seok from Medical Science Graduate School. Now, how is medical science going to change in the future? Now, so far, medical science and bioscience have been quite different than the traditional engineering. Rather than the strict theories that we see in math or physics, it was mostly empirical and based on experiments. But then now, in the future, I would say that it is going to be more about experiments. Now, if we also think about all the different animals that are being sacrificed in the experiments, we also have the rituals to soothe the animals that have been used for labs. So, of course, it does not seem compatible between KAIST and the lab animals. Now, what we see is that there are huge changes with the genetics, big data, AI, and robots. And if they continue, then I would say that the medical science and the bioscience are going to be completely different 50 years later. They will be completely digitalized. So in the next 50 years, we will be able to accurately predict the reactions from the human body, so the digital cells or the digital organs, so we are going to have the digital twins that will allow us to have the experiments utilizing these digital devices. Now, in the medical and the bioscience, as long as we have innovative ideas, then we will be able to put them into everyday lives very quickly. So then, the digital scientists will turn into researchers. So then, for the medical students in the next 20, 30 years will look back to these days when we experiment on labs as the old traditional days. And we will continue to march forward so that we will be able to realize such days. And they say that the life is about birth and aging, disease and dying. And now this is also going to change, meaning that the aging and diseases are also going to be reduced. And we will also find customized genetic information, and also the innovative early diagnosis will allow low-cost, high-efficient medical system. For example, cancers, which is also a big problem, we will be able to have early diagnosis of the cancers, and also the cancers can be effectively treated much more quickly, meaning that there will be fewer terminally ill patients. And also the anti-aging and also even the reverse aging study that are underway in KAIST, if they continue to develop, I believe that that would also help enable happier and longer lives for everyone. So far we have talked about the robotic engineering, new materials, AI and bioengineering that will be realized in the next 100 years by KAIST. And I hope for your continued interest and encouragement for KAIST as it marches on to the next 100 years. Thank you very much. So we have just looked back to 50 years ago and then also look forward to the next 100 years. And also I have also seen Dr. Jung Geun Mo on the screen when he was much younger. And without him, KAIST would not have been here, and also Korea would be quite different today. And also the professors have also shared with us the new future that will be free of illnesses, and also there will be less aging, and also no animal lab animals, so that is also going to be very helpful. So once again, thank you very much, and let us give a big round of applause to Dr. Jung Geun Mo, President Shin Sung-chul, as well as the four young professors. Thank you very much. Thank you very much, and as was mentioned earlier, the 10-10-10. So I also look forward to the 10-10-10 leading even greater achievements to KAIST. Thank you. And also listening to the four young professors give us reassurance about the future as well. And now we have also prepared a very meaningful part of the program, and that is awarding ceremony to those who have enabled KAIST. And now, right now, the award is currently being deliberated by the government, and the awarding ceremony will be held later on to commemorate the 50th anniversary. And now, we are going to have President Shin Sung-chul to present the award, and also Mobile Hubo is going to help him. So now, on behalf of the 25 recipients, we will be presenting the award to two. And also for those who are participating online, please also join us in congratulating them. So now then, here is President Shin Sung-chul.
I'd like to also invite Hubo up on stage. And next, I'd like to invite up on stage Professor Kim Gil-chang on behalf of the faculty, and Mr. Choi Hyun-sung on behalf of the staff.
네, 두 분 탄상으로.
Yes, please come up on stage. Apologies, it's Ms. Choi
Hyun-sung.
So please stand in front of the president. First, we will hand over the certificate of merit to Professor Kim Gil-chang. Actually, it's going. The Hubo actually handed it to president. So, honorary Professor Kim Gil-chang, during your tenure in KAIST, you have contributed greatly to the advancement of KAIST. And as we celebrate the 50th anniversary, your contribution have inspired many of the faculty and staff members at KAIST. February 16, 2021, President Shin Sung-chul of KAIST, please give a big round of applause to Professor Kim.
네, 고맙습니다.
Thank you very much.
이어서
Next, Ms. Choi Hyun-sung. Hubo is assisting us with the award ceremony.
인문사회융합과학대학 교학팀
From the staff team, senior staff member Choi Hyun-sung. During the past 41 years working at KAIST, you have shown unrelenting commitment and dedication to your work at KAIST. Celebrating the 50th anniversary of KAIST today, we would like to recognize your contribution. February 16, 2021, President Shin Song-chul. Please give a big round of applause to Ms. Choi as well.
자, 이제 앞쪽을 향해서
Please face the front, the cameras.
수상하신 두 분께서도 역시 나눠 주셨는데요.
Yes, our awardees shook their hands. Now please face the camera and show your plaque of merit. And if anyone would like to hand the bouquets, please do so now.
잘 보이게 들어 주시고요. 정말 지난 시간이 또 계셨기 때문에
So I believe that it was thanks to these award recipients past that we are able to celebrate today. So we're going to take a commemorative photo and please give a big hand to our recipients. Thank you very much. I would like to ask our three guests to step down the stage. And Professor Kim Gil-chang and Ms. Choi Hyun-sung, but we also have other recipients below the stage. So we have Mr. Kim Jae-gwan, Kim Jae-gyun, Nam Soo-woo, Kim Chung-gi, as well as 17 online participants, and Lee Young-nae and Bong Won-gil as well. Please give a big hand to our award recipients. And I would like to thank President Shin Sang-chul and Hubo once again for handing over the awards. Commemorating our 50th anniversary, we have received a lot of congratulatory messages from our guests. So 15 congratulatory messages that you will have a look at right now.
대한민국 과학기술연구와 교육의 요람인 우리 카이스트가 개교 50주년을 맞았습니다. 축하드립니다. 지난 반세기 카이스트는 우리 국민이 신뢰하는 글로벌 선도대학으로 눈부시게 성장해 왔습니다. 과학기술 연구 성과는 경제발전의 초석이 되었습니다. 총장님과 교수님, 교직원, 학생 모두가 하나가 되어 열정과 헌신으로 빛나는 금자탑을 쌓아왔습니다. 4차 산업혁명과 포스트 코로나 시대의 불확실성, 변화의 파도가 몰려오고 있습니다. 대전환의 시대입니다. 우리 경제를 추격형에서 선도형으로 혁신하는 새로운 도전의 시기이기도 합니다. 도약과 혁신의 중심에 카이스트가 있습니다. 대한민국 경제와 과학기술의 미래는 여러분들의 창의와 열정을 요구하고 있습니다. 카이스트인 여러분, 새로운 반세기 대한민국 국민과 인류의 더 나은 삶을 위한 여러분의 도전과 열정을 응원합니다. 성취와 보람이 함께 하시기를 기원합니다. 감사합니다.
개교 50주년 축하드립니다. 카이스트가 50번째 생일을 맞이하면서 이제 카이스트는 세계적인 과학기술 문명을 이끄는 인류 문명을 이끄는 선도적 대학교로 성장 발전했습니다. 이 모든 것은 카이스트의 재학생 여러분, 또 카이스트를 졸업한 동문 여러분, 또 교수님 모든 분들의 노고가 담겨 있고 또한 국민 여러분들의 정성과 뒷받침이 덕분이라고 생각합니다. 국민과 함께 카이스트 50번째 생일을 축하합니다. 이제 카이스트는 100년, 200년을 바라보는 출발선에 다시 서 있습니다. 이제 카이스트는 비단 지역과 대한민국 차원이 아니라 세계 인류 문명을 이끄는 선도적 역할로서 잘 해낼 것을 기대합니다. 이 인류가 맞닥뜨린 지구적 문제, 바이러스나 에너지나 기후변화나 이런 등등의 문제에 카이스트가 역할을 톡톡히 해주실 것을 기대합니다. 저도 카이스트의 꿈과 비전이 활짝 펼쳐지기를 응원하겠습니다. 또 뒷받침하겠습니다. 다시 한번 카이스트 50번째 생일 축하드립니다. 감사합니다.
I'm delighted to wish guys a very happy 50th anniversary. MIT celebrated its 50th in 1911. It was an incredible moment of hope and promise in our history. MIT came into being at the time of the American Civil War with just 10 faculty members. 50 years later, it was the largest institution of its kind in the US. Now KAIST stands at its 50-year milestone, looking toward exciting new frontiers. You have all the world before you and many paths to explore as you grow, evolve, and carry out your mission.
KAIST 개교 50주년을 진심으로 축하드립니다. 지난 50년간 KAIST는 대한민국의 대표 과학기술 연구기관이자 인력 양성기관으로 대한민국 과학기술 발전을 이끄는 중추적인 역할을 해왔습니다. 특히 1989년 현재 위치인 대전으로 이전하여 30여 년간 과학의 도시 대전의 상징으로 함께 해왔습니다. 대전 시민이자 대전 유성구가 국회의원으로서 카이스트가 이곳 대전 유성구에 자리 잡고 있다는 것에 대해 늘 자랑스럽게 여기고 있습니다. 4차 산업혁명이란 변화의 물결을 목도하며 대한민국 과학기술의 미래인 카이스트의 중요성이 어느 때보다도 커지는 것 같습니다. 앞으로 우리 카이스트가 50주년을 넘어 100주년을 맞이하고 대한민국의 과학기술 발전을 위해 더 큰 역할을 해주실 것을 기대합니다. 카이스트 교수진 및 교직원, 학생 여러분, 그리고 모든 과학기술인 여러분께 감사와 응원의 인사를 드립니다. 카이스트의 꿈을 응원합니다. 감사합니다.
세계 최고 연구대학인 카이스트 개교 50주년을 대전 시민과 함께 진심으로 축하드립니다. 카이스트는 대전을 대한민국을 대표하는 과학기술 도시로, 대한민국을 세계 10대 경제 강국으로 이끈 주역입니다. 150만 대전 시민은 카이스트를 늘 자랑스러워하고 또 고맙게 생각합니다. 50주년을 계기로 해서 세계 인류의 새로운 삶과 미래 가치를 창출하는 세계 최고의 혁신대학으로 굳건하게 자리매김하길 기원합니다. 새해에는 카이스트 구성원 모두가 굵직한 소처럼 계획한 모든 일을 이루는 뜻깊은 한 해가 되기를 소망합니다. 카이스트 화이팅!
On behalf of Northwestern University, it's my pleasure to congratulate you all on your 50th anniversary. You have so much to celebrate. KAIST has rapidly risen within the ranks of the world's great universities, and to have achieved what you have in only a half century is truly remarkable. We are honored that Northwestern is one of your academic partners, and we, as we collaborate in material science and in law, among other fields, and we would love to do even more together in the future. We are so very proud to be the alma mater of President Chin, who not only received his PhD here, but who last year received our Distinguished Career Achievement Award in Engineering. Congratulations once again. We cherish our partnership and we wish you every possible success in the years ahead.
대한민국 최고의 대학 카이스트의 개교 50주년을 진심으로 축하합니다. 50년이라는 세월 동안 카이스트는 대한민국의 경제 발전과 국가 과학기술 발전의 1등 공신 역할을 해왔습니다. 카이스트 발전을 위해, 대한민국의 발전을 위해 많은 역경과 시련을 극복하고 노력해 주신 신성철 총장님을 비롯한 많은 교수, 연구원, 학생, 직원분들의 열정과 노고에 깊이 감사드립니다. 국가의 위기 상황일 때마다 보여준 카이스트의 활약은 어려운 환경 속에서도 대한민국이 해낼 수 있다는 희망의 밑거름이 되었습니다. 저는 국민의 한 사람으로 또 카이스트의 든든한 후원자로 오랫동안 카이스트의 발전을 응원하며 지켜보겠습니다. 카이스트는 분명 대한민국과 인류의 미래를 밝게 열어갈 것이라고 믿습니다. 다시 한번 개교 50주년을 진심으로 축하드리고 지난 반세기의 업적을 뛰어넘는 새로운 100년을 기대하겠습니다. 카이스트의 건성을 기원합니다. 감사합니다.
카이스트 개교 50주년을 축하합니다. 그동안 카이스트의 교수, 학생, 직원 등 모든 구성원과 신성철 총장님을 비롯한 역대 총장님들의 열정과 헌신이 만든 카이스트를 자랑스럽게 생각합니다. 우리나라의 산업 태동기, 국가 경제 발전을 위해 설립된 카이스트는 우리나라가 최빈국에서 세계 10대 경제 강국으로 성장하는 데 크게 기여하고 이제 인류의 행복과 미래의 가치를 창출하는 글로벌 대학으로 성장하였습니다. 서울대학교 모든 구성원의 마음을 담아 여러분의 끊임없는 혁신과 열정을 응원합니다. 앞으로도 서울대학교와 카이스트가 서로 신뢰하고 응원하면서 국가 발전과 국민 행복, 나아가 인류의 행복한 미래를 만드는 든든한 동반자로 함께하길 기대합니다.
I would like to extend my best wishes to KAIST in celebration of its 50th anniversary. KAIST is South Korea's first technical university and a world-renowned institute for science and technology. Tsinghua and KAIST share a solid foundation for long-term partnership with ongoing faculty and student engagement and remarkable achievements in advanced scientific research. I envision a bright future in KAIST's successful path of continuous development with the guidance of its Vision 2031 plan. Tsinghua is committed to its role as a partner of KAIST and will strive to strengthen our cooperation. 五周年校庆快乐. Congratulations on the 50th anniversary of KAIST.
KAIST 개교 50주년을 축하합니다. KAIST가 우리나라의 학계, 산업계에 미친 영향과 공헌은 지대했습니다. 그동안 배출한 수많은 인재들이 각 분야에서 주요 역할을 하면서 한국의 발전에 기여했습니다. 이러한 성과를 위해 노력한 모든 분들께 경의를 표합니다. 제 자신도 카이스트에서 배운 반도체와 엔지니어링의 개념 덕분에 지금까지 성장할 수 있었습니다. 그러한 기회를 만들어준 모두에 감사합니다. 이제 카이스트도 변신할 시기입니다. 지난 50년간 카이스트가 우리나라의 발전에 기여했다면 다음 50년은 인류와 세계를 위한 새로운 모델을 개척해야 합니다. 새로운 시대에 걸맞는 인재를 육성하고 세계를 선도하는 연구를 기대합니다. 감사합니다.
I wish to congratulate you on the great occasion of the 50th anniversary of KAIST. The relationship between the University of Tokyo and KAIST officially started in 1998 with academic and student exchanges by the School of Engineering, which expanded to include the Graduate School of Frontier Sciences. We have a long history of friendship and collaboration, giving our members the opportunity to gain experience in new forms of education and promote mutual academic inspiration between Korea and Japan. I hope we will be able to continue our mutual friendship and build on our relationship into the future. Thank you very much.
Congratulations on the 50th anniversary of KAIST, with greetings from our Max Planck Institute in Germany. I think the last 50 years have been an interesting and very successful time for science and technology, and it is impossible to predict what will happen in the next 50 years. I'm just looking back at the incredible development in material science. With the first processor announced 50 years ago, the field of integrated electronics began, and with the first practical semiconductor laser, a revolution started not only in the field of information technology, but also in medicine and manufacturing technology. Now we have entered the area of robotics, artificial intelligence and quantum information technology, and the combination of physics, chemistry and biology is becoming increasingly important. In the future, however, we need to focus much more on sustainable development with clean energy as a driving force. I'm sure that KAIST will contribute to these goals and wish you every success. All the best for the next few years.
카이스트의 개교 50주년을 축하하고 기념하는 이 자리에 함께하게 되어 매우 기쁩니다. 카이스트 개교 50주년을 진심으로 축하합니다. 우리 카이스트는 1971년 개교 이후 우리나라 과학기술, 산업계의 수많은 리더와 중추적인 인력을 배출하여 왔습니다. 6만 4천여 명의 우리 동문들은 세계적인 경쟁력을 갖춘 우리나라의 주요 산업 전반에서 활동하며 그 누구도 예상치 못했던 큰 업적을 일궈내고 있습니다. 한국 산업의 미래를 열어갈 첨단 연구 분야에서도 우리 동문의 리더십은 빛나고 있으며 우리나라 과학기술을 이끌어 나가고 있는 사람들도 바로 우리 동문입니다. 이렇게 눈부신 성장을 거듭하기 위해서는 국내는 물론 전 세계 곳곳에서 공헌을 하고 있는 카이스트 동문들의 노력이 계속되어야 할 것입니다. 우리 동문들의 단합된 힘이 결집되어야 세계 최고 카이스트로 우뚝 설 수 있습니다. 저는 동문회장으로서 우리 동문들이 각자의 분야에서 최고의 진가를 발휘하도록 뒷받침하는 동문회를 만들기 위해 열과 성을 다하겠습니다. 감사합니다.
After having worked with many different institutions in Korea for more than 15 years and heard again and again about the leading role of KAIST, it is a matter of pride for me today to be a member of the President's Advisory Board and thus be connected with KAIST. I very much regret not to be in Daejeon today, but I hope that you can accept my best wishes for your anniversary today. All the best. Let's look forward. Let's conquer COVID-19 and be together again in the future.
제가 몸담은 크래프톤의 다양한 게임들, 특히 배틀그라운드는 전 세계인들이 즐기고 있는데요. 이 또한 아시아 최초로 카이스트의 인터넷이 설치되고 제가 인터넷을 누구보다 먼저 경험했기 때문일 듯 합니다. 제가 인공지능이 중심이 된 현 정부의 4차 산업혁명위원회 초대 위원장도 맡았었는데요. 그 당시 알게 된 사실 중 하나는 인공지능을 이끄는 다양한 분야의 리더들 중에 카이스트 출신들이 많다는 것입니다. 어쩌면 인공지능연구소가 90년대 처음 한국에서 설치되었기 때문일 듯 합니다. 이제 과거 50주년을 넘어 미래 50주년을 바라봅니다. 그러기 위해서는 소중한 카이스트를 더욱 빛낼 수 있도록 카이스트의 중요한 의사결정을 하는 지배구조, 즉 카이스트의 거버넌스가 잘 지켜지고 발전하기를 바랍니다.
네,
박병석 국회의장님을 비롯해 영상으로 축하 메시지를 보내주신 모든
Speaker Park-byeong-seok of the National Assembly as well as other distinguished guests for the congratulatory videos. Today, we are pleased to be joined physically by Mayor Heo Tae-jung, Chairwoman Lee Soo-young, Chairman Jang Byung-gyu, and President Jung Chil-lee of Alumni Association. Can you please rise and greet the audience? Please give them a big round of applause. Thank you very much.
네, 고맙습니다.
Thank you.
이렇게 또 오늘 함께 해주신 덕분에 오늘 이 자리가 더욱 더 빛난 것 같습니다.
Thank you for honoring this occasion with your presence. Next, we also have prepared a very special program for all KAIST-ians to get together celebrating our 50th anniversary. So this song actually sends a message of hope, telling everyone to get through these difficult COVID-19 times together. The song is actually a soundtrack from a Korean drama called KAIST, titled Opening the World with Your Heart. It was sung together by 60 KAIST-ians in Korea and abroad. So please have a look. 영상이라고 하니까 and they also produced this video themselves. It's quite inspiring. And I think the lyrics keep on lingering in my head. So what an inspiring song. What an inspiring moment for all of us to open up the future. So faith in me, So I think I will long remember the lyrics, and I could really feel the warm heart of all the KAIST-ians. Thank you very much for the wonderful performance. Now, unfortunately, we have to move on to the last part of today's ceremony. Last but not least, we're going to have a commemorative group photo session with all the participants attending physically and virtually. First of all, I would like to invite up on stage guests who are here on site, Chairman Kim Woo-sik, Dr. Jung Geun-mo, President Shin Sung-chul and his wife, as well as Auditor Kim Son-ha and Jung Ji-il, as well as Kwon Se-jin, and the speakers, the four young speakers, Park Hyun, Yeom Ji-hyun, Shin Ki-jung, and Ju Hyung-seok. I would also like to ask Park Kyu-won to come up on stage. 단상 위로 자리해 주시기 바랍니다. 또 아울러서 온라인으로 함께 해주고 계신 We also have 140 KAIST-ians joining us online. I know that you have prepared your messages, so please put up your messages commemorating our 50th birthday. Make sure that we can see your faces as well. Yes, thank you very much for this wonderful message, our online KAIST-ians. So please make sure that the messages can be well read on the screen. And now we're going to proceed with the photo session. I think that everything is set. So we are going to put behind Leading Korea today and move towards Leading the World tomorrow. And we're going to capture this very precious moment in photo. So on the count of three, please say Leading Korea today, all our offline participants and all our online participants. Please respond by saying Leading World tomorrow. So Leading Korea today for offline and online Leading World tomorrow. So we are going to now mark a new centennial for KAIST from today. On the count of three. One, two, three.
한국을 빛낸
Leading
50년.
Korea today. Leading the world tomorrow. Ladies and gentlemen, please face the center, the camera. So we have chanted the slogan, Leading Korea today and leading the world tomorrow. Now this brings us to the end of today's program for the anniversary ceremony. We look forward to your continued support for the next centennial for KAIST. Thank you very much, everyone, joining us virtually and physically for staying with us until the end of the program. It was a great honor to lead you through today's event. This was Jung Jae-min and Jang Sun-young. Thank you very much.